Well, good morning, dear learners. I welcome you all in the session on consignment accounts, part 4. Well, friends, as I had discussed earlier, that under the consignment system, there are two parties, consigner and consignee. So consigner is a person who asks the consignee to sell the goods on the behalf of the consigner. The risk is entirely of the consigner. Simply the consignee sells the goods on the behalf of the consigner against a fixed amount of commission, and the risk is of the consigner. So here the consignee acts as a agent. So in this session we will discuss when the goods is sold by the consignee on the behalf of the consigner, then the amount of goods which remain unsold at the end of the year. Under such a situation, how the unsold stock is valued, and as far as the normal loss and the abnormal loss that took place during the whole process, how, you know, the normal and abnormal loss impact the valuation of the unsold stock. Sometimes the normal loss takes place, but the abnormal loss does not. Sometimes the abnormal loss takes place, but the normal loss doesn't. But sometimes what happens, that when normal and abnormal loss takes place simultaneously, then how normal and abnormal loss will be recorded in the books of the account, what sort of accounting treatment will take place, and what would be the impact of normal and abnormal loss on the valuation of unsold stock. This we will discuss today in the present session. So let's discuss effect of abnormal loss on valuation of closing stock. Well, friends, the value of the closing stock is also affected in case of abnormal loss. Let us see the effect of abnormal loss on closing stock under both situation. When abnormal loss occurs in godown of the consignee, valuation of closing stock is not affected because expenses incurred after reaching godown of the consignee are not to be taken into account for the purpose. So one of my very sincere advice to my learners is that they should try to understand that any amount of expenses incurred by the consignee after reaching the goods to his godown will not at all be considered while making the valuation of the closing stock. Hence, the normal formula will be followed for the valuation of the closing stock. Whatever procedure we have followed so far for the valuation of closing stock will be repeated. But it is not so when the abnormal loss occurs in transit. So when the goods is dispatched by the consigner, but it has not reached to the consignee so far. It is still in transit, and if during transit, if any abnormal loss takes place, then how the valuation will be made as far as the unsold stock is concerned, this we will be discussing today. The closing stock valuation is also affected due to abnormal loss in transit, because some non-recurring expenses may be incurred after loss has taken place. Hence, when such loss occurs in transit, you will have to distinguish between the non-recurring expenses incurred before loss and non-recurring expenses incurred after loss. The non-recurring expenses incurred before loss relate to the total units consigned, whereas non-recurring expenses incurred after loss relate to the remaining units. So here the learner should try to understand that once the goods is dispatched by the consigner, and if the abnormal loss takes place during transit. So if normal and abnormal loss takes place during transit and the non-recurring expenses are incurred by the consignee after the abnormal loss takes place, then we will have to see that any non-recurring expenses either incurred by the consigner or by the consignee will relate to the total units consigned, whereas any non-recurring expenses incurred by the consignee after the loss takes place, then only the remaining units will be taken into considerations while calculating the proportionate expenditure of non-recurring expenses on the valuation of the unsold stock. Therefore, the expenses before the loss will be proportionately divided among the total units, whereas the expenses incurred after the loss will be proportionately divided among the remaining units. So I think it's very, very clear. So we will try to understand this with the help of the illustration, that how closing stock and abnormal loss are calculated and treated when such a loss occurs in transit. On June 10, 2018, Modi and Company Patiala consigned 500 cases of goods costing rupees 150 each to Sethi and Company. So here Sethi and Company is the consignee, whereas Modi and Company is the consigner. On the same date, the consigner paid rupees 2500 for freight and carriage, rupees 1000 as loading charges, and rupees 1200 for insurance. On 1st July 2018, consignee paid rupees 1800 for clearing charges, rupees 1750 for warehousing and storage charges, and rupees 900 for packing and selling expenses. The consignee also remitted a bank draft for rupees 15000 as an advance against the consignment. On July 5, 2018, the consignee sold 275 cases at rupees 200 each. Sethi and Company is entitled to 5% commission on gross proceeds of sales. It is found that 50 cases have been lost in transit. So this is the abnormal loss. Abnormal loss is of 50 units. Sethi and Company submitted an account sale on July 10th, 2018, prepared the necessary ledger accounts, in the books of the consigner. So let us see that how the accounts will be prepared in the books of the consigner. So in the books of Modi and Company. So here Modi and Company is the consigner, and the consigner will prepare the consignment account and the account of consignee. So here yes, two goods sent on consignment. So let's see how the goods sent on consignment, 500 cases of 150 each. So if we will multiply 500 multiply by 150, then the amount comes 75,000. So this is consignment account debit to goods sent on consignment. So this is 75,000 rupees. Two bank accounts. So these are the expenses which are incurred by the consigner. So here the consigner has incurred 4,700, and for this total amount the journal entry would be consignment account debit to bank 4,700. Let's check it. So the consigner paid 2,500 for freight and carriage, 1,000 for loading, and rupees 1,200 for insurance. So if we make the total of 2,500, 1,000, and 1,200, the amount comes to 4,700. Then to Sethi and Company. So it means these are the expenses which are incurred by the consignee, 4,450. Let's check it. So here the consignee paid 1,800 for clearing charges, 1,750 for warehousing, and 900 for packing. So if we make the total of this, this, and this, these are the total expenses incurred by the consignee. So the amount comes 1,800, then 1,750, it means 3,550 plus 900, 4,450. Then to Sethi and Company commission 2,750. So let's see what it says about the commission. Sethi and Company is entitled to 5% commission on gross sale. 5% commission on gross sale. So what is the amount of gross sale? Let's check it. Yes. On July 5th, 2018, they sold 275 cases at 200 each. So if we multiply 275 into 200, it comes 55,000, I think. Yes, 55,000 by Sethi and Company, 55,000. So 5% commission on this, 5% of 55,250. This is the amount of commission. To profit and loss 4,665. So this is the balancing figure. It means excess of this credit side over the debit side, which we call net profit, 4,665. So total is 91,565. Let's come to the credit side. So this we have already discussed. Now by abnormal loss 7,970, and this is the by consignment stock. This is the value of unsold stock, 28,595. So total is 91,565. So here these are the two figures which we need to calculate: abnormal loss 7,970 and the valuation of unsold stock is 28,595. So let's calculate how does this amount comes. Yes, first of all, abnormal loss. So in order to calculate the amount of abnormal loss, the formula is very simple, number of abnormal loss units. So it is mentioned in the question that 50 units were lost during transit. So total number of abnormal loss units is 50, multiply by cost price per unit. So cost price per unit it is given in the question, 150. We can check it. Yes, costing rupees 150 each. Plus non-recurring expenses up to the point of loss. So non-recurring expenditure up to the point of loss 4700, multiply by abnormal loss units. So abnormal loss units is 50 divided by total units consigned. Total units consigned is 500. It is mentioned in the question. So if we calculate it, 50 multiply by 150. It is 7500 plus yes, it is 4700 and multiply by 50 divided by 500. So if we calculate this, it will come 470. So it's very simple. It is 7970. This is the amount of abnormal loss which we have calculated. Then the next one is valuation of closing stock. So number of closing units 175. So total 500 units were consigned. Out of 500, 50 units were of abnormal loss. So remaining is 450. So 450, and you can see it, total 500 units. Out of 500 units, out of 450, 275 units were sold off. It means 175 units are unsold. Yes, number of closing units unsold, 175 units. Cost price per unit 150, it is mentioned in the question. So cost of unsold stock is 175 multiplied by 150, it comes to 26,250. Now the non-recurring expenses before loss, it is 4,700, already given in the question, 2,500, 1,000 and 1,200. So total is 4,700. Since these expenses are incurred on total consignment on 500 units, the proportionate amount of expenses for the consignment stock will be, so these 4700 amount represents the 500 units. So what it will represent if the number of units unsold is 175? So the amount come 1645. Now non-recurring expenses after loss is 1800, that is clearing charges of the consignee. As they are incurred after the consignment reaches the consignee, it would relate to the 450 units, because in the transit out of 500 units, 50 units were lost. So the consignee received only 450 units. So this amount of 1800 represents the 450 units. Then what it will represent if the number of units unsold is 175? Then this amount comes 700. So now the value of closing stock will be cost of unsold stock 175 multiplied by 150, because total 175 units are unsold and cost of each unit is 150, total it comes 26,250. So these are the proportionate non-recurring expenditures, and these are the proportionate non-recurring expenditures of the consignee. These are the non-recurring expenses of the consigner. So total it comes 28,595. So this we have calculated, and the same 28,595 can also be calculated with the help of this formula. But again, this procedure is very simple. So this is the amount of unsold stock which we have recorded in the credit side of consignment account, 28,595. So total is 91,565. Now Sethi and Company, it means consignee account. So this is the sale proceeds. Entry was consignee account debit to consignment. So to consignment 55,000, total is 55,000. Here the consignee has dispatched an advance to the consigner of rupees 15,000. The entry was bank account debit to consignee, so by bank 15,000. These are the total expenditure of the consignee, by consignment 4,450. This is the total amount of commission of the consignee, by consignment 2,750, by balance carried down. So this is the balancing figure, 32,800, total is 55,000. This is the goods sent on consignment. It's very simple. Goods sent on consignment, it was sent 75,000. So any amount which is sent on consignment has to be transferred to the trading account, because goods sent on consignment belongs to the goods, and any amount of goods is transferred to the trading account, to trading account 75,000. So this we have calculated. Now, where normal and abnormal losses occur simultaneously. So far we have discussed the amount of abnormal loss, how the abnormal loss is calculated, and what would be the impact of abnormal loss on the valuation of unsold stock. Now the question arises, when normal and abnormal losses occur simultaneously, then how normal and abnormal loss will be treated in the books of the account, and what would be the impact of normal and abnormal loss on the valuation of the closing stock, unsold stock. Well friends, you had either the normal loss or the abnormal loss on the consignment, but it is quite possible that both normal and abnormal losses occur simultaneously in connection with the same consignment. In such a situation, abnormal loss will be calculated as usual, but the valuation of closing stock needs special attention as the normal loss is also involved. Let us discuss with the help of an example. Yes, illustration: Deepak Oil Mills Cochin consigned 2500 kg of castor oil to Madhu and Company. So Madhu and Company is the consigner, whereas Deepak Oil Mill is the consigner. Varanasi on 1st April 2018. The cost of oil was 18 rupees per kg. The consigner paid 1900 towards carriage and freight and insurance in transit. During transit, 250 kg oil was accidentally destroyed. So this is the abnormal loss units, for which the insurance company paid rupees 2200 in full settlement of the claim directly to the consigner. Madhu and Company, that is consignee, took delivery of the consignment on April 10 and accepted a bill drawn on them by Deepak Oil Mills of 5000 for 2 months. On June 30, 2018, the consignee reported that 1,750 kg oil were sold at rupees 25 per kg. The expenses of the consignee were 1,850 towards the godown rent, advertisement and salaries of the salesman, and the consignee is also entitled to a commission of 3% plus 2% Dell Creator commission. Madhu and company further reported a loss of 20 kg due to leakage. So this is the units representing the normal loss. Prepare necessary ledger accounts in the books of the consigner. So let's see first consignment account in the books of the consigner. So here consigner is the Deepak Oil Mills. So consignment account. First of all, two goods sent on consignment. So let's see 2500 kg. The cost of oil was 18 per kg. So if we will multiply 2500 kg of goods at the rate of rupees 18 per kg, it will come 45,000. Two goods sent on consignment, 45,000. Two bank consignor expenses. So these are the expenses which have been incurred by the consignor. It is mentioned in the question. These are the expenses incurred by the consignee. It is also mentioned in the question. To Madhu and company, 3% commission, normal commission, 2% Dell Creator commission. So friends, as we had already discussed, that Dell Creator commission is also given on the gross sale until or unless mentioned otherwise. So here nothing has been mentioned. So therefore, this 3% and 2%, total 5% commission will be given to the consignee on the gross sales. So here the gross sales is 43,750. So if you calculate 3% of this, it will come 1,330. And if you calculate 2% on this, it will come 875. So total it is 2,188. This is the net profit, 7,294. So this is the balancing figure, excess of this credit side over the debit side of the consignment account. Total is 57,232. So this is the sales, 43,750. So it is mentioned in the question that only 1,750 kg oil has been sold, and the rate of oil sold per kg is, let's see, 1750 kg oil was sold at the rate rupees 25 per kg. So if we multiply 1750 by 25, it comes to this 43,750. By abnormal loss, 250 kg, it is mentioned in the question that 250 kg oil was lost. So the value is 4590, and this is the value of unsold stock, 8892. So total is 57,232. So now these are the two figures which we need to calculate. So let's see how the amount of abnormal loss has been calculated and how the valuation of unsold stock has been made. It's very simple. Yes, first abnormal loss. So number of abnormal loss, it is mentioned in the question, 250. Cost price per unit, it is mentioned rupees 18 per kg, plus non-recurring expenses before loss. So it is mentioned non-recurring expenses are 900 rupees, multiply by abnormal loss units, so it is mentioned 250. Divided by total units consigned, so it is mentioned 2500. So 250 multiplied by 18 is 4500, and if we calculate this, it comes to 90 rupees. So total is 4590. So this is the amount of abnormal loss. Now the next one is value of unsold stock, that is the closing stock. So it's very simple, number of units and cost. Total quantity and cost of oil, total, you know, 2500 units were dispatched, costing rupees 45,000. Add non-recurring expenses. So non-recurring expenses 900. So the cost is 45,900. Units remains the same. Less abnormal loss, 2500 units are abnormal loss, and the amount of abnormal loss we have calculated 4590. So after subtracting this amount from this, it comes 41,310, and it comes 2250. After subtracting 250 from 2500, it comes this. Normal loss is also reported in the question, 20 units. So after subtracting 20 units from this, it comes 2230 units. Amount is 41,310, because from the normal loss nothing has been realized. Number of units sold 1750. So out of 2230 units, 1750 units have been sold. So it means unsold units are 480. So now we can calculate the value of 480 units will be, yes, it is the value of 2230 units is 41,310. It means this cost of 41,310 is representing 2230 units. So what it will represent if the number of units unsold are 480? It will comes 8,892. So this is how we have calculated the 8,892 is the value of unsold stock, and 4,590 is the amount of abnormal loss. Now, abnormal loss account, very simple. 4,590 we have already calculated. Out of this, 2,200 has been paid by the insurance company. So this is the net loss which we will charge from profit and loss account. 2,390, totally 4,590. This is the consignee account. This is the sales amount, 43,750. These are the consignee expenses. This is the consignee commission by bank. This is the advance given by the consignee to the consignor. This is the balancing figure, 34,712. Total is 43,750. So this was all about this session. I think with the help of this exercise, my students are now very, very clear as far as the valuation of closing stock is concerned, and the calculation of normal and abnormal loss is concerned, and the impact of normal and abnormal loss on the value of unsold stock. So this was all about this session. Thank you very much. कहाँ गए राजेश जी?